2. We're trying to find out the top 4 teams from North America.
I feel like out of all the hosts so far, Axel Toss, he does alright, but he doesn't really command the same presence that Golden Boy and Scott Cole did. I feel like Golden Boy and Scott Cole were a lot more like, you know. Oh, look at how much fun James and Carpenter are having. Oh, that was cute. That was cute. Anyway, yeah, I feel like Axel's a little bit more of a quiet guy. Avengers versus Wii. Am I hyped for the 2v2 Gfinity tournaments next month? Absolutely, Noir. Noir, as Mike Rules would say. Noir. Noir. I love Noir, though. Do I recommend turning stiffness up? I would say at least 0.3 stiffness is what you need. At least 0.3, or maybe 0.25. You need a little bit of stiffness in your camera for me. Can you link a pop-up shot from Rizzo? Well, sure, you can link it, but it's going to get deleted by Nightbot, and anybody with better Twitch TV can click it if they want to, and I probably won't relink it myself or watch it, because I've seen every goal that needs to be seen at this point.
But either way, both these teams are—they're going to be going head-to-head. These are going to be one of their tougher matchups today.
Safe to say, both of these teams are definitely in contention for that top four.
You're at 0.3 stiffness right now after seeing Natalie Dormer. That's fair play.
Very elite teams in the European region. When you have elite teams, like, these are literally the best players in the world on the pitch. This is really exciting to watch for our purposes. But we're about to get into the game, so I want to get predictions from you guys. Who do you think is going to take it?
Well, on paper, we Dem Girlz is the best team. They score the most goals a game, scored the most goals in the last RLCS. So they are ferocious. And also, just we had the opportunity to talk to Doomsy, me and Gibbs, on our DFH locker room. And Doomsy was saying
just listen into the casters.
A lot of problems with we Dem Girlz. So I'm going to say it's going to be a 3-2 in favor of we Dem Girlz.
I'd have to agree. You know, the tough part is I haven't been able to see Supersonic Avengers at this stage. Teams tend to perform a little bit different when there's a lot at stake. They tend to bring their A game a lot of times, or sometimes the opposite.
So we Dem Girlz definitely the favorites, really well, I'd say.
But I do think we Dem Girlz overall is going to have the advantage. I think I gotta actually agree with you on this. As much as I like contesting.
Yeah, I would have agreed. I think 3-2 is a pretty good prediction. 3-2 we Dem Girlz.
Awesome. Well, should be a close game. Should be a great game with plenty of highlights.
The second most obvious score would be 4-1 we Dem Girlz. But saying 3-2 we Dem Girlz is not a bad prediction.
Thank you, Axel Sauce. We are down on the field, and this is a match I've been looking forward to.
Yeah, but yeah, I could totally have seen 4-1 as well, because we Dem Girlz tend to have Supersonic Avengers number when they're full strength.
And I like how James actually brought it up. Despite them being on DFH with Doomsy and saying that we have troubles against we Dem Girlz, he still gives it a 3-2 because it shows how strong both these teams are.
Yeah. I mean, like, Supersonic, again, we missed them in the last qualifier, but I think they have a lot to prove. They have a lot. We need some points here, guys. We got to get some points. They're probably shooting for the top.
Remember to always put your FOV as low as possible and your height on full. Oh, dear.
Expect that to be soon. You saw both of them just getting a 5-0 in this and that's going to help it tremendously.
But yeah, we Dem Girlz definitely the favorites coming into this, not just because of like their power ranking position, but I don't know. Supersonic Avengers are not. I don't think they perform the best under pressure. I feel like Supersonic Avengers, when the pressure is on, sometimes get a little bit worried. And I didn't actually know that Doomsy had been on DFH locker room and had publicly stated that they have problems against we Dem Girlz. Knowing that, I might have been even more worried for Supersonic Avengers going into the series. That was news to me when James mentioned that, because I didn't catch their show. James and Gibbs, of course, doing a talk show every week, which is very interesting. Apparently he's the best player in the power rankings. Those power rankings need to be rethought then, don't they? Ah, it's a decent cap by Doomsy. Bit of a panic clear right there from Snasky and ALMP. It looks like right from the beginning, Supersonic Avengers are just going for the hard clear option, which is not wrong. Hard clears are very effective if you can get that ball right on top, right over the incoming attack. Doomsy's got a bit of a he had a bit of time, but then we Dem Girlz are just so fast that that time and space suddenly turns into nothing. They have issues against F3. Is that what he said? So what did Doomzy say anything about how they do against Weedem Girlz? Doomzy having a little bit of a fight in the goal, but Doomzy really committed hard for that demo. He didn't like drive past the goal going for the demo, he drove into the goal going for the demo, which is very different. If you're driving into the opposition goal, you're increasing your recovery time duration substantially. So I'm not a massive fan of that play, unless the shot is much more high percentage than it was. Good play by Snaski. He waited out to see if Maestro would redirect that. Does ELMP have the coolest looking car around? Nah, that would be me. I'm the best at car designs. I've got the best car designs, mate. Has to be said. Ask Scrubkiller. Scrubkiller will confirm that I've got the best car designs. Every car design I've ever come up with has been probably top 10 car designs. Not a good clear by Lamp right there. That's kind of what I pointed out earlier in a Flipside game, where Marky went up into that position, and instead of slamming it into the ceiling, he just hit it lightly, because hitting it lightly in your own corner makes the ball arc more slowly. If you just... Oh, is that ELMP own-goaling it? A bit unfortunate. ELMP on a sharp rotation, I don't know why. Might have ungoaled that, but back to my previous thought, if you slam that ball into the ceiling, it's going to fall down into an attackable position much sooner than if you just arc it slowly into the air. Oh, Doomzy's way out to play. He must have gone for a super high aerial and got beaten to the ball. How do I think Supersonic will do overall? I think they'll make playoffs. I think they're going to come fourth ahead of the Flying Dutchman, but I can't see them winning the whole thing. I can't even see them beating either Flipside or Weedem Girlz. I can't see it. That's the biggest issue for them, is I just don't see them being able to beat Flipside or Weedem Girlz. I could see them beating Mockit. Mockit's style kind of lets Supersonic Avengers have the space that they need to take shots, and Supersonic Avengers are very good at shooting. So I could see Supersonic Avengers beating Mockit, but as it stands, that's not going to happen until the third place match, because I don't think either of those teams are favorites against Weedem Girlz or Flipside. Oh, a lovely bow tie by Remco. Yeah, Doomzy just not back in the net in time to turn his car and then, you know, approach that ball aggressively. Really, really fast play by Remco. One of the fastest players in threes is Remco. What do I think about those who keep one design all the time and those who switch it up? I prefer people who keep the same design for at least quite a while. I like players having their own style of car design. Although I'm a massive fan of Mockit EU, all using the same car design for their games, I think more teams should look to do that. Come up with like a team car design. Doomzy again just getting beaten to the ball. He's not getting up preemptively for that, and if he doesn't get up preemptively, he's not going to beat Greasy, Remco, Maestro. They're just too fast in the air, and with the ball moving away from the wall, Doomzy, Remco, Maestro are always the favorites. Oh, I got a Snapchat from Flarky. Better check this one out. I've got terrible internet. I'll hold it up. Get the good connection. Yeah, Supersonic Avengers just can't get a footing in this game. They're just getting completely dominated in the air. ELMP this time on a sharp rotation back to net and just can't do anything as the ball goes up above his head. Esper is love, Esper is life. Yeah, Esper I've heard is some pretty good shooting. Oh yeah, the title's wrong, my bad. Let me change that. I'll update the title to match the game that he's actually playing.
A little bit of possession, challenging that himself, actually sets up his team. Maestro off the backboard, and Remco with another shot. That's going to go a little bit wide. Doomzy takes it away. ELMP to support. We'll see if they can move that up the field. If he can get a good enough control, but Maestro takes that off the top of him.
Why don't they call him Lamp? That's what his teammates call him anyway. Yeah, calling him. I think ELMP at this point should just rename to Lamp. I really feel like ELMP should just rename to Lamp. That would be a good play in my opinion. I should be a coach. I coach a few teams. I coach Crying and Jewels in EU, Genesis in NA, and I've got the Australian teams. I've also worked with them as well. There's quite a few teams that I've worked with.
Good job at Doomzy recognizing that there was an open net, but probably should have played it a little bit slower. Oh my gosh, that's like
But the biggest problem right here for Supersonic Avengers is none of them are being proactive when they're defending against the Weedem Girls' backboard rebounds. Everybody's kind of sitting, they're rotating very sharply straight back into the net, and, you know, that doesn't really put you in the best position to attack a ball as it rebounds off your back wall. You need to use the wall to get up quick enough to intercept that ball, or just stay at the side of the net so you can get up for it quicker, because you don't have to, you know, predict a ball that's bouncing off a wall above your head. Speaking of getting up quick, Doomsy, really good redirect there. Beautiful, beautiful play. The air roll really made that shot possible. It's such a difficult question. Is that the color caster, Lawler, asking Leaf, the play-by-play, what SA need to do to get back into it? Leaf's like, wait a minute, the play-by-play guy. I'm not supposed to say what I think, but I do like a bit of a conversational test, so I'm alright with that. I hope Lawler didn't get in trouble for switching roles mid-cast. What does ELMP stand for? I have no idea. Absolutely no idea. Greasy has pink sunburst wheels, but he didn't use them. What? Greasy's pink sunburst wheels are beautiful. Did he actually not use them for the series? What a misplay. Huge misplay by Greasy if he didn't use them.
Two goals brings it a lot closer match for the second game. If they can keep that in their mind, hey, we did good.
It's a decent celebration by Weedem Girlz, Remco and Greasy just disappearing from this from the screen. I feel like it would have been better if they all went up to the ceiling together, just left the screen completely. Yeah, yeah, you're right, Lawler. You're right. I'm okay with a conversational cast, like I said. That's so tough to do. I say it like as it caught Leaf by surprise a little bit. He was like, and also it was a really hard question. You're like, what does Supersonic Avengers need to do to beat Weedem Girlz when they're losing 4-1? It's tough. Like, what do they do? I mean, I would say just don't rotate so sharply into the net, because we saw Doomsy twice and ELMP once just going straight back into the net, making a U-turn and getting beaten to the ball as it rebounded off the backboard. Flarky just Snapchatting me his new shoes. Looking pretty good there, Flarky. Looking pretty good. Pretty fly for the white guy. You're saving that energy for the RLCS Grand Final. What are you on about? What about prioritizing by back post positioning against the backboard instead of the goal? Yeah, I think I just said that. Is that not? I think I didn't read what you said right there. Go. Goat just keeps tweeting or keeps Snapchatting me pictures of myself. Goat, stop it. Stop Snapchatting me pictures of myself. But yeah, so long as these backboard rebounds are coming in so much and so fast for what's the name? Weedem Girlz, I feel like wider rotation and defense is the biggest thing that Supersonic Avengers need to prioritize. That's what they're lacking, because again we saw ELMP and Doomsy just sitting in front of the net and they couldn't get up quick enough, because when you're in the middle of the box, the ball kind of goes over your head and you have to turn off ball cam to have any real idea of what's going on around you. But if you approach from the side of the goal, you can leave ball cam on and have perfect vision of what's happening in front of you. Yeah, Weedem Girlz definitely capitalizing on the weak backboard defense by Supersonic Avengers this series. Just generally outpacing them as well. Like, Weedem Girlz are just winning the races to the ball. They're just being more, quick, they're being faster, they're being more confident. Doomsy doesn't know how to half flip, maybe. Just reversing all the way. The ball's actually come to him and he just soft clears it. Yeah, that's not a great play by Doomsy. Just passing the ball straight to Greasy right there. That's alright, halfway dead. I believe you. I'm not going to check it. I believe you. Doomsy admitting on a talk show that they have problems against F3. I mean, it's probably more of the same. It's just their defensive rotation isn't quite there. Besides the underuse of the back post for defending purposes, I feel like SA are just, they're passing away possession too much. You need to be so efficient with your possession and with your boost against a team like Weedem Girlz, who are just so quick. They punish, like, Weedem Girlz really, really steal your boost a lot. You need to be so efficient with it. Yeah, they've got to stop passing the ball away so much. Oh, the bumps by Remco! Oh, man. Remco cleans out the goal, and Maestro's like, oh, it's open. Thanks.
to secure that goal.
That's gonna. He's
gonna all right. Good night, Yummy. Take care, dude.
As he's just in there playing aggressive, leaving wide open net for his teammate. 2-0. Weedem Girl sits up on Supersonic Avengers. We'll see if Supersonic can pull up.
What was I saying? Oh yeah, Supersonic Avengers. There's also, we haven't been able to see this problem this series because they've been under pressure so much, but very often when Supersonic Avengers are the team that's pressuring the ball, the last man back will kind of move forward when a hard clear is presenting itself. Oh dear. Just, again, too much eagerness to get into attack when, look, this is such an obvious center ball by Greasy and Lamp just not spotting it. Sometimes they do this where the last man back, be it Lamp, Snasky, Dooms, it doesn't matter, they always just kind of move up when a hard clear or a center ball is just, it's right there. It's just happening and they just don't see it. Sometimes even a shot will be happening and the player on SA will just continue to drive forward into an aggressive position. It's something that Flipside do much better than SA do. Oh, what a shot by Doomsy. When Flipside have a last man back advancing forward, it'll be because there's no, like, danger in front of them. I mean, Remco could have probably saved that if he just got up a little bit quicker, but the shot was really, really good by Doomsy, to be fair. What up, Vikings are better.
They were gaining momentum at that point, and this could be the point we see Supersonic turn it around. We're just about hitting the halfway mark. It's Snasky just a little bit off on that shot, but they still have an opportunity to keep that moving forward.
Doomsy said F3 is harder to read because they have more often two people going for the ball, while Weedem Girls is easier to read for them. Yeah, that's why they're 3-0 down, right? I mean, SA just keep giving the ball away, like this. Like, what is this? It's just, they're passing it away. They're not being efficient with their possession at all. Oh, Maestro should have passed it back. That was really good. Good passing. I mean, Flipside are definitely very hard to read because they're all great 1v1 players. So individually, they, you know, do things that surprise people more often. Don't hit it away. No, it's not going to work. Actually, it might work because Greasy also hit it away. But see, whenever Weedem Girls are, like, attacking the ball, there's usually somebody else ready cycling in to follow up, and you really only have a breakdown when the whiff happens. But for the most part, Weedem Girls' rotation is one of the best, if not the best, in the world. Oh! Oh, wait a minute.
The ball took kind of a weird touch off the ceiling here, as we finally see Snasky starting to come in and contest these. And as that ball hits that weird angle, I don't think
Greasy didn't rotate deep enough into the net, and he couldn't get on the right side of the ball there. Probably expecting it to fall off the wall, but it just fell straight down. So a bit of a misplay by Greasy.
They can have this, but Supersonic starting to creep up on them. Approaching that final minute of gameplay.
I'll mention it, Greasy, and you're gonna listen. There's nothing you can do. Do I think the new IBP would demolish the old IBP? Probably not demolish, because the old IBP has Gibbs, who is, you know, solid in defense, something that the new IBP lacks. If we assume that the old IBP, we're talking about current day Sad Junior, Crow, and Gibbs, and we'll assume that they all have the same synergy as they had before, but their personal skill has improved. Like, obviously, the skill level of Chronovi now is better than the old Chronovi, so that's a bit of an unfair comparison. Uncontested shot in the midfield by Greasy. Somebody should really be challenging that. Just an uncontested ground shot right there.
Gives it that power with that nose. Power. Yeah, there's a shot. Doomsy just wide. They're trying still their hardest to pull this back. But Weedem Girls up 2 goals with 40 seconds left. This is going to be a very, very hard fight now.
Oh, what a bump. Really good play by Maestro. I like that. He realized that the ball wasn't going to be reboundable, so he just bumped Doomsy instead. Really good play. Doomsy using the champion boost. I've not been using my champion boost because so many bad players are using the champion boost. I was like, meh. Don't like it anymore.
Supersonic Avengers. Doomsy tried to play that into the corner. Unfortunately, it passes back in the middle.
How is SA rotation? Can you talk about it more? Offensively, SA have got a pretty good rotation. When I see SA in attack, they tend to attack the ball very well one at a time. And they shoot the ball very well. But defensively, I feel like they're just too sharp. They get stuck in the goal too often. But against teams like Dem Girlz, that's not going to work. You can't just be idle sitting in the goal, because they're gonna rebound early. They're gonna hit their shots too hard and high for you to handle. You need to be more active.
Supersonic still trying at least to get some points on the scoreboard, but it looks like it's gonna be over in game number two for them as Dem Girlz takes it, and I'm gonna curse it here. Five. Yeah, it's six.
Challenger boots, where it's at. I really like the prospect boost. I think the prospect boost and the star boost are the best ones. Great clear by Doomzy. I mean, it doesn't matter at this point, but you don't want to be letting other goals in, watching more replays of yourself getting scored on. Pretending he doesn't want to be one of them. I don't want to be a bad player using champion boost. I'd rather be a bad player not using champion boost. Ooh, Lamp failing to catch the ball. Ah, a bit of a sort of synchronized. Oh, there we go. That's a synchronized. Again, Remco falling down, though. That was really good by Dem Girlz, all jumping up together. But then Remco coming back to the ground. Definitely going to have to give them a 7 out of 10 for that. If Remco had flown off the screen, we could have been looking at an 8 out of 10 for that celebration. Maybe even an 8.5. But, you know, Remco really ruining it at the end. Great up until that point, though. Really great celebration.
And that's just not enough. You need to put more shots on net against the Dem Girlz team. Force them to rotate it out of their defense rather than them clearly taking that transition. Like, the ball, as soon as it hits them on the defensive side, they find a way as a team to push it up as a group and then just punish you for it.
The low five controversy? What low five controversy? I mean, the biggest problem for the actual problem for Supersonic Avengers is they're just not dealing with the pressure enough. They're not rotating properly in defense. They're letting themselves be beaten to the ball because they're not putting themselves in positions where they can attack the ball. They're putting themselves in positions where they can defend their goal, but they're not putting themselves in positions where they can attack the ball and beat Dem Girlz to the ball and control their own boost. I imagine that they're getting boost starved a fair bit here because they're sitting in the net, not using the back well enough. Like we're seeing Snasky do it right here. He's just sitting in the net and he has to play very, very reactively. Yeah. He got bailed out by ELMP, but when this happens, like, ELMP's approaching that ball correctly, but then Snasky Doomsy, nobody's rotating in for the follow-up, and Greasy just really, really reliable and quick in the air.
Being up there, like, this guy is so good.
They're all good, but, like, he's just been showing up, that is for sure. Maestro.
Esper is, apparently it's like a brick in the air. Like, whenever you hit the ball in the air with the Esper, your car just doesn't move at all, because it's just like an absolute block, solid block. So, well, at least that's what I've heard, because sometimes you hit the ball in your air and your car like bounces off it a little bit, but not the Esper I've heard. That's better. Good play by ELMP. Nobody really following up on this, though. And then when they do follow up, everybody kind of out of position. Nobody was... That wasn't a particularly good clear by Greasy, but nobody from SA was ready to just come straight at that ball, which is kind of surprising. And again, we're just seeing too many people sitting in the net, doing nothing. That shot from Remco wasn't even that powerful, and it nearly undid SA, because they just have two people sitting in the net. They're not using their back wall to defend faster, like this, which is obviously far more effective. Just getting in the net and sitting there. Look how reactive you have to play. If Greasy puts that shot in the net, it's just going to go in. Nobody's attacking the ball. Some pretty poor shooting by Dem Girlz here. But Supersonic Avengers just sitting in their net is just not how you deal with this. Danger high voltage over the stream. I'd love to, Mike, but YouTube would copyright claim me. You'll DDoS me, Spleen Shadows. I do like a bit of danger high voltage. We'll do that after this series and after the Flipside versus SA. I'll stick danger high voltage on if I remember. I'll open it up in a tab right now. Like, Dem Girlz have kept this scored at 1-0 because their shooting's terrible this game.
3 minutes left. That's going to go in front of Supersonic's nets with Maestro with a shot.
Was saved by Lamp. And they keep it out. Oh, no way! Oh, Doomsy couldn't get around it. Oh, what a shame. What a shame. That was such a good save by Lamp. And then Doomsy nearly getting around it in time. He didn't actually have to rush it as much as he did. I think Doomsy was just like, uh-oh, ball on the goal line. Quickly, get it off the goal line, and then he un-goaled it.
Very close, good attempt, but that went in, putting Dem Girlz up 2-0. Approaching that halfway mark.
Dem Girlz up 2-0. Leafix doing his best like,
Maestro can get a shot here.
Yellen P with the aerial interception. Well, Leafix, he sounded a bit like one of those, like, machines that you have to talk to when you call your telephone provider. Push. 1-4. Calls. Regarding. Payment. Any call not regarding payment. Call back another time, because we only want to steal your money. For poor service.
Can a third be in to challenge that? They're going to leave that for ELMP as Doomzy falls up. The demo from Doomzy. Greasy, though, with the back shot just
oh, no way. Oh, man. The quadruple whiff right here. Quadruple whiff in the RLCS group stage. Oh, man. Remco even whiffing at the end there. Just let it roll straight in. Oh, not the best defending by SA. Again, Leafix with the automatic phone teleprompter response. 3-0, WeDem Girlz. I think as he's just focusing so hard on getting the score right, because Leafix has had a bit of a reputation of saying, oh, and WeDem Girlz tie up the game with 3-0 on the scoreboard. They're like, wow, they take the lead, 3-all. Leafix, of course, having a lot more difficulty than any other caster, identifying when the game is a draw and when it isn't a draw. Oh, your BF's going to be at the LAN, is he, Mike? That would be interesting. Have you talked to Clydefuel yet about getting your flights organized now that you boys are guaranteed to qualify for the RLCS? I'm not sure if you knew that, Mike, but you're guaranteed to qualify. I imagine you didn't know that already. You'll have to hit up Clydefuel, sort out your flights, and then tell me what plane you're flying on so I can hop on there as well. Hopefully all from Scotland, of course. We can have a night out in Scotland. A night out in the town. In Glasgow. Or maybe even Edinburgh. I don't know. If you're going to be flying out from Edinburgh or Glasgow, one of them might be cheaper than the other. Then we could just go over it. Go and stay at some cheap accommodation in Edinburgh for a day. Tying it up 3-2 in the series. Doomsy tying it up 3-1. Beautiful equalizer by Doomzy. Edinburgh, aye, that's what we say, Edinburgh in Scotland. Bruh, Edinburgh. That's where Scrubkiller's from, he's from Edinburgh. What's saved by Lamp? Actually, could have had a counterattack in the go there if somebody was a little bit quicker. It looked like Snasky had no boost though.
Up on that one, loses on the touch. Doomzy to push forward, but a little bit too late on that. Leaves it for Greasy. Maestro back to the center. Greasy to challenge, but that's on target.
Oh, Remco's way back. I guess he just doesn't want to concede at this point. Yeah, I've got a Scottish light accent. I could put on heavy one if I want to, but I tend not to. You heard Glasgow greater than Edinburgh? Edinburgh is nicer looking, and the people are more posh there. But Glaswegians are funnier, and, you know, plenty to do in Glasgow. Synchronized jump, is it coming? That's better. Again, the jump wasn't quite so synchronized. Ah, and Remco again! Just floating back into the screen, completely ruining the synchronized celebration. It's like we're watching synchronized swimming here, and one of them is just a bit off. Remco, both last game and this game, needing to up his synchronization. Your accent's way heavier than mine. Yeah, Scrub's got a bit of a heavy Scottish accent. Not really. We're both pretty light Scottish accents, to be honest. And a couple times that they don't, that's when Supersonic Avengers has been scoring, where they're controlling where the ball's going to go rather than... Yeah, Remco's endgame celebration just really isn't there, is it, Greasy? It's very poor. I mean, I was timing it myself. I believe if you're in a ranked game, after your rank like pops up on the screen, like whatever, Rising Star or whatever, after that happens, count 4.5 seconds and jump. And if you do that, like, it freezes bang on 5 seconds after the Rising Star or whatever, Challenge Elite Prospect, whatever it is. After that thing comes up, 5 seconds after that is when it freezes you. So if you count 4.5 and jump, then it'll freeze you all in the air. And it's like one of those shots from a film where you just, or, I don't know, like those shots on Facebook where everybody's jumping. It looks kind of funny. Alright, see you later, Luller. I'll talk to you later, man.
More consistently, they need to make sure that WeDem Girlz is starting to have to rush to things because they look just so calm and collected. Right,
Lolly's got to go wash his pants. He's got to do adult things.
As you mentioned, now we're coming into game 4. WeDem Girlz up 3-0 in the series. Supersonic trying to get at least 2 points.
Why does Leafix still sound like one of those automatic response systems? Freedom Girls up 3-0 in the series. It's weird. I've never heard him like this before.
Come into game at number 4, 30 seconds in, both teams trying to make a move, no goal scored yet.
Don't be at me too hard while you're gone. I'm going to go so deep right now, Luller. Gonna go right in there. Ah, my back. I need a better chair, man. This chair is rubbish. Somebody donate me a fancy streamer chair. You would like to know a good channel that streams 1v1. You want to be checking out. Mike sometimes does 1v1. Mike Rules, he's in the chat. He's a good 1v1 player. He doesn't play much ones on stream these days, but he's a very good 1v1 player when he does. Marky Duda's probably the person who streams the most 1v1 at the very highest level. Scrub Killer streams ones at high level.
But he put it right back on the net. Luckily, he got that chip.
I know Kaelin X streams a lot of ones at high level. Kaelin X.
They have a team play to bring it out, and so far they just haven't done that. But they are showing sights of it. Like, when they work as a unit, it's very tough to beat them.
Who else streams high level ones? Pashy, I suppose. Not seen him streaming much ones recently, though. Almost allowing Doomsy to move forward. Yeah, I said Kaelin, yeah.
Pushes forward and finally gets out of their own end. And there's a shot, no, from Greasy.
Bit of an over-rotation by SA. I think we had a team bump situation. Or situation, if you will. Yeah. Is this Doomsy smashing Snasky out the net? I wouldn't be surprised if that was Doomsy smashing a teammate out the goal. Doomsy's not the most aware of his teammate surroundings in and around the goal. He just kind of drives across the goal and bumps a teammate right out of there. I've seen him do that far too often for my liking. Probably cost him a goal right there.
And it's so hard playing against Weedham Girls, because even when you're on the attack with the drop here, can someone follow it up? That could be a scoring opportunity.
Oh, what a save by Remco.
Just keeping that one out. ELMP trying to keep that play alive. We'll see if they can get another...
ELMP having to do a U-turn there, because he moved in really, really close. I feel like if he just stayed farther back at the edge of the box, he would have had a higher percentage angle on the ball.
And a good clear. He's going to try to follow us up. ELMP, the last one back, needs to push this one out.
Oh, you bet I will. I'm going to trash talk Doomsy all day. Nothing you can do about it, mate. Nothing you can do about it.
On the attack now is Widom Girls. Now they have to move back to defense as Supersonic putting on, as I said before, some good pressure and starting to show off.
Yeah, Doomsy definitely has bad habits in and around the goal.
And you saw Doomsy trying to rotate back in. Those are the glimpses that I'm talking about.
He's got the highest peaks of any player from SA. Like, he, when he's on, he's really, really, really good. But sometimes he has off games and he, you know, gets a bit greedy, starts to rotate poorly. He's still a very good player, though.
Someone should be here waiting for it, and ELMP is rotating back, trying to get a good windup on it, but he puts it into where no one is. Maybe dribble it a little bit. Take some time with it, man.
This is not the best play. Okay, it turns out into a good play. Snasky almost ruining it here. Decent pass by Snasky to ELMP, then... Actually, is it Snasky by Maestro? That's a beautiful shot by Doomsy. Really good pass by ELMP as well. I really felt like that pass was too central by Snasky, but ELMP actually had idea of what to do with it. The reason I'm saying that pass wasn't the greatest is because if you pass it straight on target, you take away the option for your teammate to redirect it onto the net pretty much, because any time they touch it, it's going to be difficult to get it to stay on target. You can, but it's much easier if you put the pass off target. But ELMP used it really, really well. He found Doomsy in the midfield, and nobody from Greasy, Remco, Maestro saw it coming. It was quite difficult to see where Doomsy was, mostly due to autocam. So I almost called it as a bad play, but then I saw Doomsy coming as, oh, never mind. It's fine, because Doomsy's in the right position. Past ELMP, this could be the opportunity. Personally, I would prefer if the entire game was spectated through player cam. Just different players. Like right here, after ELMP makes that whiff, you could switch the player cam to somebody else. Yeah, Snasky, could have been better. It wasn't bad, though. It was good that you kept it low, Snasky. It's good that you kept it low. A lot of people will try and hit that pass high, and it makes it much harder for their teammate to do something reliable with it. Doing low passes is definitely the way to go if there's no if there's no enemy player between you and the teammate that you're trying to pass it to.
Supersonic can get a shot off here. Maestro just keeps that to the side.
Yeah, they're in a really good position now with 20 seconds left.
Good pass by Doomzy.
Remco, good push to the side.
Yeah, I feel like Snaski should probably shoot that ball high into the crossbar, because by putting it on target, he just puts it too close to the goalkeeper, and the goalkeeper is going to get that most of the time at this level of play. Shooting it high into the crossbar would have made the goalkeeper second-guess himself. He's going to think, okay, it's going over, but should I go up for it or not, kind of thing. Oh man, what a heartbreak. What a shot by Maestro though. Holy cow. Man alive, that's just so, so heartbreaking for Supersonic Avengers. That's a huge comment and advice most esports casters make. What is? Talking too much. I missed something.
And Weedem Girls just showed that to Supersonic Avengers and winning that one. 0 seconds.
Okay, now look at the difference between this game and how close it was.
I think the casters at RLCS do a pretty good job. Like,
they only had 3 saves.
They're doing what they're being told to do. You have to realize that they're casting in a way that they're being told to cast. This is a production that's being run very deliberately. And, oh, I missed the celebration, my bad. I got distracted by chat. Anyway, but Remco apparently ruined it again. No surprise there. Like, I'm sure that the casters are doing what they're doing because they're being told to do it. The production, they're never going to please everybody with the casting. You can't please everybody with the casting. There's always going to be people who prefer a more chilled-out cast. Some people have a more hype-oriented cast. Some people love, like, a conversational style. Some people love a play-by-play style. You can't please everybody, but what they can do is they can please the masses. So they have decided that the cast style that most people will enjoy is what they're telling the casters to do, and that's fine. In my opinion, I think they're doing a good job of it. Oh, what up, Stumpy? Is that your face? Is this your own emote? It is. Team Rocket RL Stumpy. Beautiful. Remco took off too slow. Yeah, standard Remco ruining them celebrations post-game.
Supersonic Avengers just trying to get a point. And it looks like to be an uphill battle for them. A shot already from Maestro on target.
Oh, man.
Man, Remco, you're such
Supersonic Avengers just here, having an absolute nightmare defending these backboard rebounds. Man, they're just getting beaten to every rebound pretty much. Snaski just rotating into a useless position right there. You've got to be more active. He kind of just followed the LMP and then he was sitting underneath the play the whole time as it happened above his head.
Early goal on for Weedem Girls.
Rip SSA? Not yet. They still have a chance. They still have a chance.
On that one quick and answer that first goal.
Like the biggest things for me for SA, just try and be a little bit more efficient with possession because their passing and shooting is very, very good. High-pitch ringing in my ear. Stupid ears, man. Why do they just have a high-pitch ringing now? I'm falling to pieces at the tender age of 25. But anyway, with the grand old age of 25, I should say, because we're in a gaming world where that is actually ancient. Oh, what a finish! There we go. See, Supersonic Avengers, great passing, great shooting, just like I said. Oh, well done. Beautiful finish by Snaski. What up, Jackie Duda? How you doing? I mean, SA or SSA.
I want to see that Supersonic
Tinnitus, is that what it's called, Michael? I mean, I don't usually get it. Just sometimes, you know, you just get that ringing in your ear for no reason. You're like, stop. Why? I don't get it a large amount of time, though. I wouldn't worry too much. Snaski shooting a bit too low. He also didn't get the power hit with the corner of his car. He could have made that hit a lot harder if he air rolled to the side, drilled it in the top of the net. But yeah, Supersonic Avengers sometimes just hitting the ball kind of pointlessly in attack, wasting possession, not controlling their boost as much as they could in defense, and letting themselves get pressured because their defensive rotation is just too sharp sometimes. They just go straight back to the net and make a U-turn instead of using the backboard more.
Yeah,
Tinnitus is that random ring in. Yeah, I was aware. Exactly, I was aware. Well, I made that connection when Michael mentioned it. You've got it for life. Oh, dude. That's annoying. Wait, you've got it, like, all the time? You have that spleen shell, is? Is it just, like, all the time there's a ringing noise? Or just sometimes? Like, often?
hoping to get another one of those beautiful goals he got just before.
There we go. So a bit of a whiff coming in from Greasy, giving a chance to Lamp. He went for the fast pass down into the center. It's not wrong to do that. What a shot by Doomsy. Well played. Again, AutoCam didn't really give us the justice on that. Oh, it's an open net. Oh well. AutoCam not really doing that shot justice because we didn't see Doomsy flying in. So that pass, even though it looks like Remco just left the goal too early. This is something that I sometimes see happening from Supersonic Avengers as well. Where somebody just rotates out the net a bit too early. He's too keen to get involved in a counterattack, and then he realizes, oh wait, this is coming straight back at my net, isn't it? Rip. You got it 24/7, you get used to it. Too many gigs. Man, that sucks. To extend their lead to 3-1, they're still trying right now.
Oh,
no.
Go off the backboard. Can somebody there pressure it? That's an open.
See, look how hard it is to defend those backboard rebounds. Especially off the curvy part of the ceiling where it meets the wall. That's why approaching from the side of the goal is much better than approaching straight from, like, underneath. Like, there's nothing much harder in defense than, like, sitting in your goal and seeing the ball bounce off that curvy part of the ceiling and then trying to, like, attack it early. It's so much easier for the attacker coming forward to hit that ball than it is for the defender, unless somebody's like going to sit in a RL trainer and just practice the crap out of that for like a long, long time, then I can't see anybody consistently defending those. You know they're going to have something to respond. You've got to use the side of the net. Just position yourself off to the side. Good dunk by Snaski. Well defended by Greasy, though. He just rebounded the ball wide of his own net, or forced the attacker to do it, I should say. Smart play, get boosted up, and now he's going to follow it up himself as LMP missed that off the wall. PSA, if you're young and going to gigs, please wear plugs. Yeah, I've heard gigs can be exceptionally loud. Can't be wrong to wear earplugs.
Girls defender was there first as they are trying to get another play, doing a very, very good job of getting this ball towards the net and getting some plays.
Doomsy just putting that pass a little bit too close to the defender right there, which allowed Greasy, I believe it was, to make it clear. Wait, I think somebody just got a, I think we just had a team bump into an aerial connection by Greasy and someone. Good pressure coming in from SA, though. They're doing much of this game of beating Remco, Greasy, and Maestro to the wall in the midfield. They must just be feeling confident now because they've taken that lead for the first time in the series. Playing it to their teammates really well here. You see, turns out Kirk has been talking this whole time, and Mike can't hear him. That'd be pretty funny. Ah, yeah, the Gibbs position. Lawler pointing out Gibbs is a. Oh, no way! Oh, the crossbar at the post. Oh, what a play! Oh, they couldn't get it in. I'm getting glad, though, because Supersonic Avengers going 5-0 would have been brutal. Good save. ELMP and Doomsy letting it drop. So we finally get to see some SA celebrations. They don't know what to do. They're honestly so surprised that they've made it to a victory that they're just overcome by shock. Snaski's dropped his controller. He's actually just head in hands crying over with happiness that they've won a game against the Dem Girlz. They've actually done it. Where's my sub button? I've never applied for one. I'll probably do it. That miss, rewatch that, yeah, I saw it. They might show it post-game, dude. They probably will. If they don't show that highlight post-game, I'll be shocked. Oh, so close. It really should have been a goal. Wide open net two times, post and then crossbar. Yeah, Greasy, why don't you have the pink wheels, dude? The pink wheels are awesome.
I love that last game. That was absolutely great. Hopefully, we'll see them do great in the rest of the series. Stay at the top.
Lawler just a stone cold killer as usual, completely emotionless. He's just seen an incredibly close ending, and he's just like, yeah, no big deal. I'm Lawler. Deal with it. You've never had a easier finish in your life. You blasted into the crossbar. Oh, I need to set up the blaster, guys. At Gree. Get it. Oh, I'm gonna blast it. Oh no, I hit the crossbar. Oh no. I do love saying blast when you're gonna hit the shot. Oh, I'm gonna blast it. I'm gonna line up the blaster, guys. I was listening to you and Remco playing. You were hitting a lot of blasts.
Absolutely.
A little bit of frame drops.
too good. They are so quick to the ball, and Supersonic Avengers really struggles with teams that just throw everything towards the ball. And we saw just
you hate the casters that watch into the camera all the time instead of looking at the dude talking. I like it in a bit of both. You know, if James is in the middle here, he wants to talk to carpet a little bit, then he wants to talk to the, you know, the host, and then look at the camera. Give the camera the, what's it called? Sex the camera with his eyes, just give it a good old, you know, good old squint stare.
No one on Supersonic Avengers was prepared for that shot. Their passes off the backboard, their reads, they're just so clinical.
It's up to James being in the middle to try not exclude somebody. He doesn't want to, like, stare lovingly into findable carpet's eyes and leave Axel toss off to the side feeling like a third wheel. You got to do a bit of both, you know, spread yourself around. ELMP caught in the middle of the net with nothing to do.
He gets so high for them as
what
well.
A pass by Maestro,
there's
though.
No hesitation, he knows exactly where it's going to be, exactly when he shows up for it.
Bedroom eyes, yeah, you got to give them those bedroom eyes.
Came up huge on the defensive side of the ball. You see that save right there, it did eventually...
Bit more awkward being the man in the middle. I feel like I could do that. I feel like I could be the man in the middle. It's a beautiful bump goal by Renko and Maestro right there.
They put themselves out of position to have to make that save.
Again, this look at Snasky right here. He's just hoping. Well, I hope that the ball gets hit straight at me, because that's really the only save I'm making. Snasky bumping ELMP, but it doesn't matter. It actually worked in their favor, because Doomsy coming out of nowhere. That was heartbreaking 0 second goal. Goal of the series by Snasky. Beautiful. Remco leaving the net open too early. Bang! What a shot by Greasy. He just blasts it into the post, or the bar rather.
Just the brick wall. Look at that. Just getting up to get that.
The good old squint stare. Yeah, you gotta do the good old squint stare, Polly. Gotta do the good old squint stare.
They're not playing against WeDem Girlz. They're not trying.
When will you know if I'll be able to cast for the LAN? I've got no idea. I'm gonna go there anyway, so. I'm going to go to the line anyway. I'm sure I'll appear on camera at some point. Probably. Easy blastage. Easy blastage. Hashtag worth.
Really critical. And they have flip side tactics later today.